So this laptop was destined for the garbage because of this tiny little connector inside for the LCD screen. Super small, super fragile, easy to break if you ever take the computer apart to repair it or upgrade or anything like that. If you were to take this computer to the manufacturer, Dell, they'd gladly sell you a whole new motherboard, probably cost you more than 500 bucks, and that would be their suggestion to repair this. Ultimately, it's not worth that, so I wanted to fix this. I didn't want this computer to go to the landfill. So I made this little nozzle for a hot air gun to get the old part off. Kind of sketchy, I know, but I did manage to get the old connector off and didn't take any of the nearby parts with it. The thing to know about these circuit boards is each of these little silver traces that you see on the circuit board, underneath that silver color, that solder, is just a very, very thin layer of copper, thinner than a human hair, and it's just barely glued down to the fiberglass circuit board, so super easy to peel that copper off the circuit board. So miraculously, I didn't do that, and I didn't blow away any of the nearby components with the hot air gun. So I put down some of the solder paste on each of these copper pads here, and solder paste is this flux with these tiny little balls of solder in it, which is great for soldering these kind of fine connectors and everything. So I put that down and I line up the connector, I line it up, I get it just perfect, it's just in line, all these little tiny hairs of these pins are just lined up perfectly, put the heat gun to it, and I melt it. So now we're back to where we started with this melted connector that I now need to remove. So I remove it same way I did before, miraculously. I don't take any of the nearby parts with it again, and then I clean up the board, I put down the solder paste, I line it up, get it lined up perfect, put the heat to it again, and I melt it again. So miraculously again, I'm able to get that connector back off without damaging anything. Managed to get the board cleaned up, and definition of insanity, I don't dare try and do the same thing I just did twice and failed. So this time I got out the soldering iron, and I went through and soldered each of the pins. Now, when you use an iron on these very fine pins like that, you're gonna bridge them all together into one big connection. So with lots of flux, lots of patience, and a million pictures on my phone just to see what I'm working on, I was able to unbridge each of these pins one by one, and I managed to save it, save the computer from the landfill.